Unboxing your battery monitor. The kit includes the user manual, the battery monitor with remote display, the shunt, and the wiring. The monitor will display all the information. The 25 feet of black cable runs between the shunt and the monitor. The red wire connects to the positive terminal on the battery and shunt. The quick start guide gives you some important details to look over before you start installing. Be sure to download the latest product manual from gpelectric.com/BMK before you begin. In this demonstration, we will show a battery monitor setup using a 100% full, 100 amp hour lithium battery, along with a power inverter and a solar charge controller. Wiring. Before doing anything, disconnect all wires from the negative side of the battery. Be sure to use wire of appropriate gauge, equipped with a ring terminal at the end. For more information about wiring gauges, click the link in the video description. To begin, connect the black wire to the shunt using the ring terminal as shown here. The negative terminal of the battery must connect directly to the B negative side of the shunt. This will be the only connection to the negative battery terminal. Tighten the bolts to the appropriate torque. It's important that all charging and discharge sources are wired through the shunt. This includes DC loads, converter chargers, and other components. If they are not wired through the shunt, it will impact the values shown on the monitor's screen. Connect the other end of that negative cable to the battery using the ring terminal. Tighten the bolts to the appropriate torque. Now it's time to connect the other power components. Stack the negative ring terminals for the other negative wiring segments on top of each other on the B negative side of the shunt. If there are too many connections, we recommend installing a battery bus bar. Then you can make all the negative connections on the bus bar and connect that to the battery monitor shunt. Tighten the bolts appropriately. Connect the negative wires from the shunt to the power inverter. Then add them to your solar controller. Your controller does not require a ring terminal at the end, but a stripped wire which is screwed into the side. Now, you can connect your positive wires. We will start by connecting the positive wire to the inverter. Again, tighten the bolts securely. Then, connect the positive wire with the stripped end to the solar controller. The other end with the ring terminal will eventually be connected to the positive terminal on the battery. Next, take the red wire that was included in the battery monitor kit and attach the end opposite the one with the ring terminal to the shunt as shown. Finally, you can now stack all the positive ring terminal ends of your components and connect them to the positive terminal of the battery. Proper stacking is important. Please always stack larger terminals closest to the battery and the smallest towards the top of the nut. You should now have everything connected between the battery, shunt, inverter, and solar controller as shown. Connect the shunt to the battery monitor using the 25-foot cable provided. If this is done correctly, the display will turn on. If everything is working properly, go ahead and disconnect the positive connections so the remote display can be mounted. Mounting the remote display. The remote display can be mounted so you can view your battery stats at a glance. Here are some tips for mounting. 1. Plan the location of your remote display carefully. 2. Keep the cable length in mind, which is 25 feet. The cable needs to be run from the shunt to the monitor with the remote display. 3. There is a handy template in the user manual that you can cut out and use to help you see where you want to place the monitor and accurately draw the proper size of the mounting hole. 4. As the monitor uses clips to stay in place, the hole cut needs to be as accurate as possible. Therefore, we recommend using a jigsaw for this purpose. Once you have cut your hole, you can run the length of cable from your battery bay and feed it through the cut hole. Then, connect the shielded cable to the remote and snap the remote into place. Display operations. Now, let's go through the different display operations. Preset capacity indicates the remaining available capacity of the battery in ampere hours. Preset voltage is the voltage measured at the battery terminals. Preset current shows the amount of current either entering or exiting the battery. Power is the amount of power either entering or exiting the battery. Remaining time is the time left until the battery is either completely charged or completely discharged. Capacity percentage displays the remaining available capacity of the battery as a percentage. Settings menu. Press and hold the OK key for 3 seconds to enter the settings menu. Click the up or down key to select the setting items. In this view, you can see the battery capacity at the top, the high voltage parameter, the low voltage parameter, and the alarm indicator level. Upon first installation, the first thing you need to do is set your battery capacity. To edit this setting, press and hold the OK button until it begins to blink. Use the OK button to move the cursor to the left. Use the up and down arrows to increase or decrease the numerical value for that selection. Press and hold the double back arrow to set this parameter. Initial setup. You will need to calibrate your monitor when it is connected for the first time. You will also need to calibrate if your battery bank is being replaced. If you are starting with a full battery, on the main screen hold the up key for 3 seconds to set the capacity to 100%. We do not recommend doing this process with an empty battery. Setting the battery capacity. Press and hold the OK button to be brought to the settings menu. Set the CAP settings by using the OK button to move left or right, and the arrow buttons to increase or decrease the numerical values. To set each numerical value, press the OK button. Once you have the proper values entered, press and hold the double back arrow to set this parameter. Then, click the down arrow to move to the next parameter to edit, and begin the steps again using the same buttons outlined before. Setting voltage parameter. The high V and low V parameters in the settings screen are used to automatically sync the state of charge. If the battery voltage is above high V, the state of charge will reset to 100%, and if it falls below low V, the state of charge will reset to 0%. Setting either of these values to 0 will disable this function. Setting low capacity alarm. This is the low battery alarm. If the battery is discharged below this limit, an audible alarm will sound. Again, setting this value to zero disables this function. We recommend that if you plan on heavily discharging your batteries, set the parameter value to zero. This will disable any alarms or resetting functions. Sleep/wake up. The monitor will go into a sleep mode if the battery current drops below a certain level. To wake up the monitor from this mode, press any key. As well, the monitor screen will automatically wake up once the battery starts charging or discharging. Turn off flashing display. While charging the battery, the LCD screen's backlight will slowly flash. This function is enabled right out of the box. To turn off the backlight, long press the double left arrow. To turn the backlight back on again, press the double left arrow for a few seconds.